So basically, it just peaceful protest. We saw people gathering around and sitting down, being quiet. It's supposed to be 17 minutes of silence for the 17 victims. And after it was over, kids started getting more rowdy and started chanting things. And I guess someone opened the door to walk out, to basically just leave school. And like everybody followed him out there, and we started walking down the road. And that's when the cops started getting involved and blocking off the roads.
And Joe, when you guys saw everybody walking out, I know you guys kind of followed along, and this really wasn't how you expected this day to go. Tell me about kind of what happened as everybody was leaving.
Like you said, it started peaceful, but then once everybody started walking out, like, we didn't have class at the time, so we just kind of followed everybody to see where it would go. And everybody started just walking toward Palmetto, like, just at least, like, got, I felt like half the square, but... we started seeing cops sort of telling us, like you might want to go back to school, it might get bad. And then we sort of drove around the other side to get a glimpse of what was happening, and really far, just people, like, gathered around, just, like, hundreds of people, and cop cars everywhere. We thought they were going to block the roads. It was pretty weird, pretty wild.
And just the whole purpose of this, obviously, taking a stand against the violence. How are you guys as high schoolers just feeling in the wake of what happened last week?
I just think it's crazy because, like, you're supposed to feel safe at school, right? Like, this is supposed to be a learning, educational environment. And I noticed, like, whenever someone opens the door to a classroom now, like, everybody looks to see who's coming in because we're all just so paranoid of what's happening. So it's crazy.
Well, thank you guys so much for sharing all of that with us. And the sheriff's office is out here. They've closed a portion of Glades Road in front of the school just to make sure that all the students are safe as they do make their way back inside of campus. We have seen quite a few students come back onto campus to continue their day. Reporting live in West Boca Raton, Stephanie Suskind, WPTV News Channel 5.